This video and all content on this channel is performed by a pest control professional, and it is always recommended to hire a pest control pro in your area to perform any pest control in or outside your home. Pesticides can harm you and your loved ones. Anyone who is performing the information in this video is doing so at their own risk. If you decide to try the info provided in this video, please always check with the local laws in your area and read the labels of any product you use. The label is the law. Hey everybody, this is Jason Akers again with Green Acres Pest Control, and today I'm going to tell you a story. I'm going to tell you a story about bed bugs and mistaken identity. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you really like it, consider subscribing to my channel. Are you the type of person to go into your bedroom and you wake up the next morning and you got bites on you and you don't know how it happened and you flip the bed up and you flip the box spring over and you search everywhere and you're looking high and low and you're trying to find signs of bed bugs, but you can't find anything? You can't even find a blood spot or a casing or anything. You can't find eggs. You can't find bed bugs, but you're positive that you have bed bugs because here you've got bites on you. So this is what I want to address in this video today. I want to tell you a story about a customer of mine from several years ago. She had a problem with bites. Okay, she was getting bites on her. She had bites all over. Every night she'd go to bed. Every single morning she'd wake up, she'd have new bites. She searched over her bedroom. She searched her house. She searched everywhere, all over the place, trying to find bed bugs. And she actually did this for several months, and the bites only got worse. And she couldn't figure out where they were coming from. She's getting these rashes on her arms and stuff. And so she called us. So went out to her house. And I was almost positive that she had fleas, because we searched for about 45 minutes to an hour, and we couldn't find any bed bugs either. And so she was positive she had something biting her. I mean, there was bites on her. She absolutely had something biting her. And so we searched the house. We were there for quite a while. And after everything was said and done, we had diagnosed that she probably had a flea problem. So we went through the whole house and we treated it for fleas. She had to be gone for a couple hours after we were done and everything. And then she came back in. The bites persisted. She still had bites. So she decided to go to a dermatologist. And she went to the dermatologist and he said, well, you don't have bed bug bites and you don't have flea bites and you don't have spider bites, and which is odd because a lot of times a doctor really can't diagnose a bug bite. So she's like, well, then what do I have? Because he had taken samples of her skin and the spots and the lesions and everything that she had and checked them all. And he said, I'm going to have to look into it. I'll call you back as soon as I get the results. So she went home, and a couple days went by, and he called her, and she called us. And so she's like, look, I got to the doctor. I don't have bed bugs. I don't have fleas. I don't have ants. I don't have, you know, these anything coming in actually biting me. She said it turned out that she had scabies, that the doctor had looked under a microscope and at the samples that she had given him and found that she didn't have any other bugs except scabies. And scabies are typically sexually transmitted, but she didn't have a spouse or a significant other. She lived by herself, and come to find out that she had a raccoon. A raccoon had gotten underneath her house and had died under her house. Animals carry scabies. Different breeds of animal will carry scabies. And when the animal died, the scabies no longer had a live host, which is what scabies typically live on, is a live host. And so they started transporting themselves up through the floor, going up into her bedroom, which underneath the bedroom floor is where the raccoon had died. And so we had to go out there and remove the raccoon. Of course, we removed the dead body and buried it and everything, and treated the house again for just general pest control for her, because she was due anyway for general pest control, and treated the whole house. And the scabies disappeared because she had to use a special cream that the doctor had given her. So the reason I wanted to go over this is because I get a lot of questions on my channel about I can't find any bed bugs. I've looked everywhere. I've treated with crossfire. I've done this. I've done that. and I'm not finding any blood spots. I'm not finding any bugs, but I'm getting bit every day. What is this coming from? What is this? What's causing this problem? Can you please help me? Can you please help me? I get calls on the phone. I go out to people's houses. They've searched high and low, can't find bugs. So there's lots of things that could be biting you, and it may not be bed bugs at all. I don't want you to assume that you have a bed bug problem just because you have bug bites, because a lot of times it's not. Even if you've experienced bed bug problems before, I feel like most commonly the people that, you know, that assume that because they've gotten bug bites, it's bed bugs, are usually the people who have actually had bed bugs in the past, and they get the bites and they're like, oh, I know this is what it is again, not this nightmare all over again, and they assume it's bed bugs. But it isn't always. It is common though for people who have had bed bugs, you know, in the past to have them again, but not always. You know, it doesn't always work out that way. So there's several different bugs you could be having problems with. One, scabies or lice. Those are two things that you could have. I have a lot of people that contact me saying that they have bed bugs living in their hair and they're biting their hair or their scalp. Bed bugs don't live on a person. They're not a parasite that actually lives on you. They live away from you. They come out, they get you, they bite you, they go back to wherever it is they're hiding. They don't actually live on your body. They're not brought in from by cats or dogs. They transport in and out of the house on other people's clothing or handbags, luggage, stuff like that. This is how you get bed bugs. Cats and dogs don't transport them. They don't carry them around. I mean, they might be able to carry them around for a couple steps, but the bed bug's going to fall off. They can't stick to the animal like a flea can. They actually get very clumsy. They're not very good at holding on to things, and so they fall pretty easily. It could be fleas. Check your carpets really well. Check your pets. Make sure your pets don't have fleas. Make sure you don't have fleas in your yard. I go over this in some of my flea videos, which I'll link in the corner below, above, and I'll put some in the description too, some links to some couple different things that may be causing you this issue. But yeah, fleas, you should always treat your yard. If you don't have pets, treat your yard. Treat all the way around the whole house, inside, outside, to try to combat the flea issue. Yeah, could be ants. Ants is another problem that it might be. So one time, my wife, she was getting bit by ants in the bed. The ants were crawling in through a window that the bed was actually right up against. This is a really common occurrence, especially in the morning and in the evening. You may wake up the next day and have bites from the ants and not even know that it was ants biting you, because they don't typically stay around. They probably come out looking for food, water, things like that. They get what they need. They go back to the colony. They've got other jobs to perform in their colony. So ants are another thing that could be biting you. But carpet beetles is probably the most common thing that I have found as far as mistaken identity when it comes to bed bug bites. So carpet beetles have tiny hairs all over their body, like fuzz. They're very fuzzy, or like a fuzzy caterpillar, kind of. In fact, they're very similar to a fuzzy caterpillar in that the fuzzy caterpillar's hair on their body is also venomous. A carpet beetle, you can actually break out from carpet beetle hairs, and they don't bite you. They don't want to feed on you. They feed on things like carpet fibers and dust and skin cells and stuff like that. They don't actually bite you. But what happens is when they crawl across your sheets, eating your hair and skin cells and stuff like that, they shed their fur on your bed, and you can't see the hair. The hair is super tiny, super, super, super small, so you're not going to notice it. But when you lay in the bed and your arm rolls over and you get one or a line of those fuzzy things on your arm, you'll break out the next day, or on your neck, or on your mid-waist section, or, you know, they do leave these little bite marks, look like bite marks, but actually it's an allergic reaction to the hair that causes you to blister. It's not an actual bite. So just because you have bites does not mean you have bed bugs. And so the reason I made this video is to try to help everybody, you know, help relieve the stress that is bed bugs. Because like I said, just because you're getting bit doesn't mean you have bed bugs. It's actually probably not the case if you can't find any signs of them. Hopefully this video has helped you. Hopefully it has taught you a thing or two about bed bugs and about the bites and stuff that you receive on your body. And hopefully you don't have scabies. But anyway, y'all have a good day. Don't forget, live streams every Thursday night. I come on typically after 9 o'clock at night, Eastern time. And we'll talk about bugs and bed bugs and all kinds of other things. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment below. And also meet up with me on Thursday nights for the live streams, and I'll talk to you there too about the same thing. Y'all have a great night, great day, whatever time it is, wherever you are. Y'all have a great life, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks. Bye.